We both had to relinquish titles due to injury, but I feel like that's where the similarities end. I've returned, became multiple time champion, where all Cross has done is simply return. So if anybody needs to prove themselves at TakeOver Stand and Deliver, in my opinion, it's Cross, because I've proven myself time and time again on TakeOver in matches against people like Kyle over here, in matches against Adam. I've proven myself time and time again that I am the best wrestler in the world. So for anyone who thinks that Finn Bálor is the underdog going into this match and that Karrion Kross is somehow going to accept a passing of the torch from Finn Bálor, they are sadly mistaken.
You're full of
Thank you, Finn Bálor.
It has been my time. And tomorrow, whatever happens, I am going to take any opportunity to win that NXT Women's title. If this past year hasn't showed anyone anything, my win at War Games over Io Shirai, or my win versus Rhea Ripley in the Last Woman Standing match, well then tomorrow I'm going to open a lot of eyes. I'm going to show everyone that I deserve this and exactly who is Raquel Gonzalez.
You can't beat me. I'll show you. This is mine.
We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Raquel.
Because when it comes to big matches, Kyle just can't hang. Again, I've proven countless times that that's exactly where I belong. Kyle hasn't done that yet. And the best part is, it's not even really about winning or losing in that sense. What it's about is hurting Kyle unlike he's ever been hurt before. Because when I made promises and when I said I'm going to beat Kyle O'Reilly, I followed through on those promises. Well, I'm promising you right here, right now, I am going to hurt Kyle O'Reilly to the point where he is never the same again.
But I can speak for my own personal life over the past 2 years. A lot has changed, as Walter had pointed out. I had neck surgery. I had a daughter. My mental game, my physical game, it kind of everything needed an overhaul. And it kind of just happened to be Walter who pointed that out to me. And I agree with him in many ways. But as far as TakeOver Stand and Deliver, I can assure you that this is the most anxious and excited I have been for a TakeOver since TakeOver New Orleans. I feel that after 16 years in this industry, for some reason, so many people have forgotten. In TakeOver Stand and Deliver, I remind the world, and I remind Walter exactly who Tommaso Ciampa is.
Now, the cruiserweight style itself was born based on what I represent, which is lucha libre. It is very important to me because I own the division. I'm not just the champion. I own and I will forever own this division because, like I said, it's in my blood. It runs through my veins. And for Jordan Devlin to overcome that, he will have to go through me. And I don't think he's got what it takes. That's my answer.
The cruiserweight style might have been born in Mexico, but it was perfected in Ireland. And you remember that. And you call yourself the interim champion when you're talking about yourself.
Thank you, Santos.